This morning in the Rhode Show Kitchen, oh, one of our favorites, Bob Burke from Potafio joins us, and today we're making...
Bacon! We always make bacon.
Yeah, all right. Well, it does involve bacon, but what's the recipe that we're making today?
No decent cook should ever start cooking without having some bacon around to eat, okay?
That's
just
true.
It's one of the first rules of cooking.
What is the dish we're making, Bob?
So we're going to make coq au vin, okay?
Which, what does that mean?
The coq, okay, is the chicken.
Okay.
O is with vin. Come on, you know vin.
Wine.
Yeah.
All right.
Chicken with wine. We're making chicken with wine
chicken
today.
Chicken with wine. All right. So let's go over the ingredients. Pretty minimal here.
You know, and here's the thing. The French are the masters of taking an old, you know, hen, tough old bird, been laying eggs forever. And, you know, it's going to be chewy if you just throw it in the oven and roast it.
Yep.
So what the French do is that they have this wonderful process, braising in wine, that they use to make tough cuts tender.
Okay.
So when you make what is already tender, okay, we got tender chicken here, and you cook it in the wine, it just tenderizes it even more. It makes it so succulent and delicious.
Well, we got a little onion, mushroom.
Onion, mushroom, bacon, a little bay leaf, just a tiny bit of tomato paste, and of course, the big old box of wine.
The box of wine. You're using what, Chianti today?
You can use any...
Fava beans and a nice Chianti. Can't help but say that when we're in the
where
kitchen.
Where did that come from?
Hannibal Lecter, you know?
Hannibal, what does he do with his mouth?
He knows I can do the impression.
That thing.
Yes,
that's
okay.
That's amazing.
We've got the box of wine, we got the chicken, and we're going to get things started in just a bit.
Back into the kitchen.
Back in the kitchen with Chef Bob Burke from Pot de Feu. Coq au vin is on the menu, and we need a lesson in chopping.
Yes, I'm going to do something I do with great frequency and do very well. I'm going to make a woman cry. I'm going to bring tears to your eyes.
Oh, great.
You now need to julienne the onion. Mm-hmm. Now, I want you to notice something. Does this look like anything to you that's familiar?
An ornament?
That little, it's not Christmas time, but here's the thing. It looks like a lily bulb, doesn't it?
Oh, it does, absolutely.
Well, you know why? Because this is part of the lily family. And this is the stem, and this is the root. And when we julienne onions, the first thing you're going to do is put your fingers over the top.
Okay.
Okay? And slice through the onion.
Like so in the middle?
No. Like this. Here. I don't want you to cut yourself.
Oh,
I'll demonstrate it.
Okay.
So we go right through like that from stem to root.
Got it.
See what I mean? So now go ahead and peel off the outer, right? We'll just peel it off.
Okay.
And remember, you know, like onions are pretty cheap. So you can just peel that outer one off.
Okay.
And we're leaving the stem on because I want you to still be able to see this because this is... People, what's going to happen is the root is going to hold this entire onion together for us.
Oh, good.
Okay?
That does not fall
so
apart.
When we julienne, exactly. Mm-hmm. So now what we're going to do is just trim a little bit off each end.
Okay.
But now you can see the root end and you know. So you're going to put the root end away from you. Okay?
Chop a little bit off.
Yeah, chop a little bit off.
Root end away.
Yeah. And now slice straight down and through. And what we're going to get instead of little diced onions when
straight
we do it this
down
way.
Down and through.
No, you can go all the way through. Cut the whole thing.
Oh.
Yeah, like that. You're good.
Let me in
you
here.
Should give up television and go into cooking.
Okay.
So now what happens, and this is what's great about it, is that these, we get the long, thin strips of onion, which is julienne.
Perfect.
And that's what we want for this recipe. Nice, long, thin strips. And by turning the onion the right way, that's what you
get. That's what we get. There it is. All right, I have julienned the onions, we've washed the mushrooms, and when we come back, we're going to finish the dish. Back in the Rhode Show Kitchen this morning, coq au vin is on the menu. I've got my apron on. Chef Bob Burke is here from Pot de Feu. Bacon sizzling.
Bacon is sizzling. We gotta love that.
All right.
What we're gonna do to assemble our dish, it's really easy at this point, is that we're gonna put our mushrooms, our onions.
Which we've julienned.
Julienned beautifully. These are some of the most beautiful julienned onions I've ever seen. And
what happens if our hands still smell like onion?
Oh, isn't that awful? That will be like all day long. Okay, see this? This is stainless steel?
Yeah.
If you rub your hands on stainless steel, the smell of onions or garlic will go away.
Look at that.
You don't even need water.
Good kitchen
tip. Isn't that cool?
Too.
So
that
they're back to
cool.
Just like smelling of bacon.
That's a good sign. I wouldn't mind having that.
You can't get off with soap and water, but onion won't come off with soap and water.
All okay? right, so you got a little sizzle there.
So what I'd like you to do is go ahead and put in four of our chicken thighs. I like using chicken thighs a lot better than I like chicken breast for this dish. Because it's got a little more bone in it, mm-hmm. and I like kind of the meatiness of this. And we're just going to put in now our mushrooms. And all of our onions. Now, I want you to notice something that we didn't do. We totally skipped a step. We didn't brown the chicken.
Yeah, I was going to say, well, that's okay. just going in as is.
We did an interesting experiment. We oven browned chicken, 450 degrees, on a sheet pan, took chicken and seared it in bacon grease, mm-hmm. spattering all over the place, and then took a third set of chicken raw and just put it in and cooked it. Guess what?
No difference.
You can skip the browning of the chicken step.
It'll save you a step in the kitchen, that's for sure.
It will save you a step. And it also makes this much more of like a crock pot kind of.
Yeah,
you can put these raw ingredients together without doing lots of saute in advance and all that other stuff. And they will come out
prep work.
Exactly the same.
Nice.
Now, the last ingredient that we have to put in for you is going to be the vino, right? I'm going to put a little bit of tomato paste.
Okay.
And then open the spigot.
There we go.
That's it.
And just any other types of red wine that we can use for this
cheap
recipe?
Red wine. As long as you would put it, just drink it. It's perfectly fine to cook with.
Okay? So that's why you're saying just buy it in a box because you need a lot of it.
Exactly. Get the cheapest wine. That's perfect. We're good to go now. And what we're going to do at this point is pick up the pot and totally sear our hands. No, just kidding. You got to watch out for this step because your pot is hot. Now, we need to cover it. The whole idea of this is that wine is going to tenderize the chicken, okay?
Yeah.
Both the alcohol and the acids in the red wine, that's why it's important that it be red wine, is that's going to just tenderize everything. It's all going to cook down together. The onion and mushroom flavor, the bay leaf and the tomato is all going to combine.
Yum.
And this is so simple to do. So the way we're going to finish it,
our chicken is still raw, so how long are we going to cook this
for? We would chance scorching it if we did this on the stovetop.
Mm-hmm.
So I've preheated the oven, 400 degrees, and we're going to put this in the oven for about 2.5 hours, and this is going to come out absolutely delicious.
It will act somewhat like a crock pot where it's that slow cooking time. It's taking its time, but all the flavors are going to soak into there.
This is the same thing that the French do with, for instance, beef bourguignon. A tough cut of beef, you put it in the wine, you put it in with your flavorings and seasonings, your mushrooms and your onions, and out come these unbelievably succulent, moist, delicious. I mean, it makes it so fantastic. It's incredible. It's also something you make a day ahead if you want to.
Hey, that's good. Yeah, that's nice. Especially, I mean, we know that everyone has a different schedule these days. Gosh, if you've got kids, they're running around from this thing to the next thing. When is there a time that you really all are sitting and eating or that you have time to cook?
Around our house.
Not every day is go ahead and pick up the fast food.
We make a big batch of this, okay?
Yeah.
And it's great if you have it the next day. Like so many chowders, soups, stews.
They're almost better the next day.
They're always better the next day. The flavors just all mingle and come together.
Yeah.
So what we do is that we have it for dinner, and then sometimes we freeze it.
Yeah.
It's easy leftovers. You just warm it up.
Perfect.
It's so moist and tender. This is a dish you almost cannot ruin.
Nice. Well, I'm excited to try it. If you want this recipe, head on over to the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com.